Hello and welcome back, all you capitalist pigs. My name is Jason Stapleton and this is the Forex Market Preview. And if it's the first time you're joining us, I'm really glad that you're here. I'm going to try and make this valuable for you. And if you are one of the over 70,000 returning, we actually have like over 125,000 people. We went through the database, but of course some people unsubscribe and of course, some people fall off the rolls or whatever the case, maybe stop watching on a regular basis. But for those of you who do catch this every single week, really appreciate that. The numbers just keep growing and growing and growing. And I'm going to try and make this pretty valuable for you. Most of you, or a lot of you, haven't talked to since the International Trader Workshop. But for those of you who are there, and of course, those of you who are in the Ratio Masters course, that's why I'm doing this late on Sunday rather than on Monday, because I actually have a course I have to teach Monday morning. So we're getting right into that, but let's go ahead and take a look at what's happened here in the market and what I'm watching here. So if we come in here, first thing we're going to look at is New Zealand. New Zealand, as you guys can remember, if you guys remember back a couple of weeks ago, we talked about consolidation here. The market breaks out, previous structure support, which was right in here, then becomes resistance. And the market formed another consolidating channel. Market then broke out of that. We watched it fall back down into. Now we're sitting right on a support level. And look at what's happened here. Nice double bottom on the daily chart. If you look at the bottom of your screen, you're going to see some very nice bullish divergence. Market was massively oversold at the time. Then we had a nice pop last week, a little gap up. The market filled the gap, but was unable to make any lower lows. So there is an opportunity here to look for some buying opportunities as the market. We look for the market to rally. Now, where could it potentially go? I'll draw on a Fibonacci retracement here, and let me just take the last leg kind of this move here. Now, naturally, this previous structure support level is going to be good resistance if we get back up there. But one of the things that you might watch out for here in the meantime, if you're looking for somewhat of a medium-term hold, now we are looking at this on the daily chart, and I try and do things on higher time frame charts just so you have a chance to take advantage of it. But I am going to show you this right at the 382, looking at 7800s, okay? Not only do we have a 382 retracement, but also look back here, previous structure resistance. And back here, even again, previous structure support, and then again, previous structure resistance. So a very nice area here of structure and Fibonacci lining up together, and that's what we like to see here. So if this market, there's nothing saying that the market's going to, going to reverse here. Well, there's a lot saying that it's going to, but what my indication here is, if we come up, we could very well see some continuation to the downside. But this market is due for a little bit of a relief rally, and so when we look at markets going oversold, then we get the double bottom bullish divergence right along structure. Looking for that rally back up into at least a 382 is, not unreasonable here. And we'd be looking at a move from about 7,500, which is where we're at right now, to about 7,800. So a very nice 300 pip move there that you could take advantage of. And again, running right up against structure, that's why we take a look at that for potentially some profit taking. Is if the market does get back up into that area, man, probably a good idea to start taking some profits off, maybe trailing those stops aggressively, some of those types of things. So just be thinking through that as you're planning out your trades and you're looking at your different options. Let's go ahead and take a look at the euro. You guys will remember a couple of weeks ago there was an advanced pattern setting up, and I thought we were going to see a little rally out of the euro, and we didn't get it. The market just has been on a straight nosedive. If I go ahead and bring in my RSI, my relative strength index here, we'll bring it down to a 7 period because that's what I use, and I'm going to go ahead and make this 80 for the upper band and 20 for the lower band, showing that extreme overbought and oversold condition. What you're going to see is market has been very oversold, starting right about here where we were looking for that advanced pattern to set up right along previous structure. We had a very oversold condition. We got just not, let me just flatten this up a little bit so you can see it a little bit better. Not right about here, we got just a very little pop, not much of anything, and then the market just took another rollover to new structure lows. So now the next question becomes, where is the market potentially going to go? Well, we actually have an advanced pattern here that the market could be setting up. This is a very deep crab pattern, and I'll show it to you right now. I'll just go ahead and draw it in. It looks something like this. Now the crab pattern should terminate around the 1618 extension. It's a very long, you can, this one long C to D leg here is what classifies. It's the hallmark of that crab pattern. You see this very deep, very elongated extension of the C to D leg coming right in around that 1618 extension. Now, as I consolidate up my chart, you can see I've already drawn a line in here. And as I consolidate my chart up, what I'm looking for is additional structure. And I don't have additional structure here at the actual 1618. I do have it a little bit higher than that. I do have it around 121.65, and that is actually the shoulders of this inverted head and shoulders pattern. Some of you may recognize this pattern depending on how long you've been trading and how skilled you are at technical analysis, but a very nice left shoulder here, then a head, then a right shoulder. And as I drive over, now that is going to put us ahead of the 1618 extension. And again, it puts us significantly away from the structure that's down here at around 118s, which is the recent lows of 2010. But if we get down there, you know, looking for buying opportunities around 121.60s, 121.80s is not going to be a bad idea. There is a high probability that the market is going to stall there and that we may see some support. Now, what will negate this for me, guys, is if we get any type of rally back up into this line, this area right here. If the market rallies here and we come back up into 126.70s, I'm going to 126.50s. This is a crab pattern. Is going to be no good for me because we're going to get a relief rally and that could just send us right down to 118s. So anyway, I'm watching this right now. We're going to see what happens. If you come down in here 121.60, nice opportunity to be looking for some buys. And I probably have some pretty nice stops right underneath these lows here, these shoulder lows, because if it's going to stop on these shoulders, it's going to stop there. If it doesn't stop there, if we get some press lower, we're probably going to go to 118s. And so I'm going to be watching both of those levels and just going to see if we can drive straight down there, it's going to be a nice buying opportunity. I'll take a chance. I'll throw some money at the market and see what it does. Let's take a look here at, what else do I got? This is a nice one. Pound dollar. Taking a look at this on the daily chart. Look at the massive sell-off that's happened here. Wouldn't you have loved to be part of that? And I don't mean to toot our own horn, but we actually did catch quite a bit of this. But market sitting at 6. I consider below 20 oversold on an RSI. So if it's underneath 20, if it's, 19 or less, it's considered oversold. This is at 6. So extremely oversold and running right up into heavy support. Look at this. Support, 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 support. If I consolidate my chart up here, you're just going to see if we get underneath this support level, that's significant because there is really nothing all the way down to 114 or 140s. So if we get under this level here, there's a high probability that this market is going to go see 142s, 143s. Now, is it going to happen? I don't have any idea. It has met some very nice support here, and if I drop this down to a four-hour chart, what you're going to see is if we put in any type of double bottom here, it's going to be a nice buying opportunity. Market's oversold. We've got a nice little ABCD pattern. A nice little harmonic move down this way. And so there's going to be some opportunity here to look for a buying opportunity. And as you can see, guys, the dollar has been overbought for quite a while now. So it's really, the natural ebb and flow of the market says that, barring some sort of massive, destruction of the Eurozone or massive international catastrophe that may happen that we're not aware of or that's not, impending, we should see this market rally just because it's going to have to take a breath. Markets very rarely do this. If you can look back on the daily chart here, I mean, how often does this happen where you just see a wave of red candles down? It's very rare. Normally you get a little bit of chop in there. You've got another really nice leg down here. But very few times does the market just show this massive red move without some sort of rally in here. So what I'm saying and what I'm getting at here is that this is going to be a nice area to look for a potential long opportunity. It's going to be very low risk because you've got this beautiful shelf here to kind of gauge it off of. And so if your guys are looking for a nice correction, that's probably going to be it. Now, again, where do we go? Fibonacci retracement. Where is the likelihood that we, you know, what are we going to see here? What just happened here? There we go. Swing high to swing low. Looking at the 382. Look left, right at that 382. Look at that beautiful support level. One, two, three tests of that support level. 382 retracement. A nice pop from around 153 to 156s. Again, another about 300 pip move. You know, really nice little opportunity there. There's about 600 pips of potential opportunity there if you're betting against the dollar continuing to decline. Now, if you do that, just be aware that when you take out a long New Zealand dollar position and a long pound dollar position, you've doubled your exposure in the dollar. So you want to be cognizant of that. It's not necessarily a bad thing. You just want to make sure that if you've got any risk exposure rules to dollar or to a specific pair, that you're now overexposed. You've now doubled your position against the dollar. And anything that might lead the dollar to strengthen even further, it could be something a little bit concerning to you, because you're actually going to double your risk. But anyway, well, there's several pretty good trading opportunities. I don't want this video to be too long. I could go into Pound New Zealand and show you the major support here coming in at basically $2, and that any retracement down into that zone is going to be a pretty good buying opportunity. But again, we'll try and keep it short, and I'll be back next week for some more opportunities, and we'll take a look at these again and just see how well we fared. And we'll take a look at some new stuff. So until next time, guys, good luck and good trading. Trade empowered, live abundant. I'll talk to you soon.